Hello again, everybody. The question today is how to price your lawn care services for residential work generally here is, I guess, what we're talking about today. So I guess the first thing is you need to know your numbers. You need to know what your costs are, okay? You need to know your cost of doing business, and that's several different things. It's you've got your labor that you have to pay. You have fuel expenses you have to pay. Maintenance, things that you have to pay for, all your oils, you know, your line, your blades, things like that. Filters for the vehicles and for the mowers. I mean, there's a lot of things that go into the maintenance part of that stuff too. But you got to know your numbers, okay? You have to know that going in. So you know you got to make a certain amount of money before you go and bid on an actual property, okay? So an example, let's just take an example. Say an average lawn is like 55,000 square feet, just hypothetically throwing it out there. And if you know that it takes you a half an hour to mow that job, or say 15 minutes to mow that job, and then you might have another 5 minutes in trimming, you know. So, you know, you're there for say 20 minutes, okay? Well, you know what your hourly rate is, and now you know you're gonna be at that lawn for 20 minutes, okay? So obviously divide that by three, plus you got to figure in your fuel and all of those expenses in there, but that hopefully will help guide you along the line here to what we're trying to get at. There's measurement tools you can use for lawns, and this will help you out, especially if you're new to it, if you're fresh to it. If you know the market rate in your area, this is extremely helpful, and it's easy to actually find the market rate. Just talk to guys. A lot of guys will share that with you. A lot of lawn care people, if you go and talk to them, you know, they'll share some of that information with you. You know, you got to know that rate going in. And if you know, let's say just for an example, in Florida, in certain areas, the average is $65 to $70 a month, okay, to come in and maintain these properties for what we call just a simple mow, blow, and go, I'm sorry. But you know what that price is going in there. So if you look at it, you could Google it with Google Earth. You can look at it and say, hey, that's your average size property. It's about 5,500 square feet. Say, okay, well, this new property that they just called on is, you know, it's a few streets away or, you know, a mile away or whatever, but it's about the same size property. One of the things that I did, we've done it a little bit. We've done some of the quoting over the phone to people, and it's come back to bite me a little bit, I think, because you don't see all the hidden things that are in there. You don't see all the obstacles that there are to mow around. What's more important to me now, and having done this for a number of years, and about 17 years now, I guess it has been, 16, 17, somewhere in there. But having done this so much, I've learned that you need to go and look at those properties, because it may be 5,500 square foot property, but they may have a dozen shrub beds that you have to edge around and a lot of trees in the yard that you have to trim around. So instead of it taking you 20 minutes to do that job, it actually took me 40 minutes to do that job. And now I'm going to lose money because I bid it over the phone without going to look at it. So don't make that mistake. Take the time, go out there and actually look at them. Okay. Yeah, we talked about how long to mow. The labor rate has got to be figured in there. Corner lot versus an inline lot. There's another thing to consider. If it's a corner lot, you know, it's on the corner of that street, you know, or down by the end of the cul-de-sac or whatever. But if you run into a corner, now you've got two sides of that. You have to edge all the way along that curb. That makes a difference. That takes time. And then you got to come back with your blower and blow everything off the street and sidewalks and whatnot. So it really pays to look at them, and that way you have a lot better understanding. Don't do it. I know there's some companies out there that are on the internet that are telling you, you know, you can do it with mylawnquote.com or do it with Google Earth or whatever and do it over the phone. Yeah, it's convenient for you to try and sell them, and that's fine. You can try that. We've done it. We've sold people on it, but it's come back to bite us, like I said. But by far, we have not landed as many customers as if you do it face-to-face. If you're face-to-face with them, it gives you a lot better opportunity. You're more personable. You're getting that exchange going on with the customer, and they like that. Okay, there's some people that just want to be emailed. They don't want the hassle, and those are the people that we'll put on our website. You know, we have a quick quote spot up there where they can click on that, and then they can choose how do they want us to respond. Do they want us to respond with a phone call back to them? Do they want to have us send them an email with a quote, or do they want to meet in person? And whatever they check off, then that's what we go with. Okay, so a lot of people, I mean, they're so busy, they don't, you know, busy professionals today, they don't want to take the time to have to come and meet with the lawn care guy. Okay, they would, some people prefer, look, man, just give me a price, just email it to me, I'll let you know if we're going to go or not. And you don't want to do that, you'd rather meet in person, but that's your only choice, so you do it. But at least it's a choice, it gave you an opportunity. Versus someone else where if the guy, same guy had called you on the phone and asked you for a price and you tried to set up a time to go meet him, he told you he didn't have time for it, he maybe is going to get frustrated because you keep pushing him and then he's going to just walk away and he doesn't even want to talk to you. So it's kind of a horse apiece. You gotta settle on some things and some differences, okay? Let's see. The trimming obstacles we talked about, edging obstacles, the average fuel consumption has to be figured in when you're thinking about how to price your lawn service. You got to know, I always, when I do it, I think to myself, where are they located? How long does it take me to get there? Do I have a 10-minute drive time or a 5-minute drive time? There's fuel involved with that. And I do that for every single job. I don't cut anybody a break because they're right next door to somebody else that we're doing. And the reason that I don't do this, and you should not make this mistake either, is because if you have these two customers and they're right side by side, and let's say you're charging this guy $70 a month, and now this guy called and he wants an estimate from you. So you go and talk to him, and he's like, come on, man, you can do better than 70 bucks a month. You know, I'm right next door. You're not even going out of your way. And you're like, yeah, okay, I'll do you for 50. Okay, all of a sudden something happens. This guy sells his house or gets a different job offer. And he just left. Now you're doing this guy for 50 bucks. You try and raise that price on him. Guess what he's going to do? He's going to drop you. Okay, don't do it. And here's the other reason you don't do it. Neighbors talk. They talk back and forth. And I made this mistake. And that's why I'm telling you. I'm telling you from experience. I've done it. I've come in and said, yeah, you're right. You're close. I'll do you for 50 bucks a month. You know, I just was thinking, get more clients. I'm not making any money off of this guy. I wasn't making it. I wasn't even thinking about that. And I should have been. When you know your numbers, you know what you've got to charge to come in that area, to work any job in that area, stick to your numbers. Okay? You got to stick to them. Just don't get off of that. Wear and tear on the equipment. You got to figure something in for that. You absolutely have to. You can't just figure your expenses and your labor and all this other overhead stuff that you have. You have to figure a little bit for wear and tear. I know, like, in Wisconsin, my business here, I have a certain amount that I allot for using my truck, and I have a certain amount I use for using the skid steer. And these are figures I put in because I know it's beating those machines up. I know it's wear and tear on the machines. If you don't put that money in there, into your estimating, somewhere in there, when that mower breaks down, you don't have the money to fix it, okay? You need to take over all your clients. Say you had 20 clients or 50 or 100. You need, if you just put $5 in all of those every week for maintenance, it would cover your truck and your mowers and things that are going to break. And they're going to break and they're going to cost you money. If you don't have it in there, you're going to be screwed when it comes time to have them fixed. You're not going to have the money to do it, okay? So there's a lot of hidden costs that need to be figured in. You know, you've got your workman's comp, your unemployment, all your office stuff, your computers and printers and ink and paper and your labor for the office people. And, there's just a million other hidden things. I know there's like the mailings and, you know, just a ton of different things that have to be figured in somewhere. Okay. Otherwise, at the end of the year, if you haven't thought about all these things and you haven't put them into your pricing scheme, at the end of the year, you're going to look at your bank account, you're going to see how sad it looks, and you're going to put your hands in the air and say, I can't do this anymore. I'm not making any money. You can make money in this business, but you've got to cover your bases. You've got to put the money in there. You've got to allot for it when you give your estimates. I don't care if your estimate is higher than that guy that comes in at $45 or $55 a month, which is a joke. I don't care what it is. It doesn't matter to me. When I come in, I know what I have to make to be profitable. And if I can sell the customer on, look, I'm an honest, trustworthy person. I'll work with you. I'll be the best company you ever had. You just try me. You'll see. And then once you get their trust and they see you work and they know you're a good company, they're not going to leave you. Okay? So remember that. A lot of these guys out there are pissed off. The clients are pissed off because their lawn guy did this to them or he did that to them. There's a million things. They've had it with lawn care guys that don't do what they say they're going to do. When they do find one that will do what they say they're going to do, they're willing to pay the extra money to keep them. Okay? So keep that in mind. Know your market rate. That's very important. When you're going out as far as how to price your lawn care services, you need to know this. You got to know that market rate. If you don't know it, call them up and ask for an estimate. I hate to do it, but do it. I mean, you got to start somewhere. You got to know what they're going for in these areas you're trying to get in. Okay? You can't go out there, build in all your prices, and you're at $100 a month per lawn when the average rate is 70. Okay? You're going to have to find ways to tweak things because you got to get somewhere in this market rate. Okay? Low ballers are at 50, 70 is the average, 80 are the top dogs out here. You're at 100. You better at least come in at around 80 or you're not going to be playing ball with anybody. Okay? So keep that in mind. Let's see. The no price break, we talked about that a little bit. No price break for the customers. You can't do it because when one leaves, you're stuck mowing them for that price. Plus, they talk. That's the other thing I was going to tell you about, and I forgot, and I got sidetracked because I talked too much. But, okay, you got two customers sitting here. This one, $70. This one, you just come in and do him for $50. He's brand new, and he talked you into doing it, so you're going to do it. As soon as this guy talks to this guy, and he says, hey, John, you wouldn't believe it, but I talked him into giving it to me for $50 a month. What's he going to do? This guy's going to quit you. He's going to be on the phone with you. He's either going to be like, you bastard, you're either going to charge me $50 a month, or I'm leaving you. Then what? Now you got two properties that you don't make anything on. So keep that in mind, please. Okay. Okay. Add it up. You got to be profitable or you can't do it. Bottom line. As far as how to price your lawn care services, you got to know your numbers. You got to do your homework. You got to study all these things I've talked about here. You're in business to make money. Remember that. A lesson that it's easy to say, but if you don't do your homework on this stuff, you're not going to make money in this business. So you've got to do your homework. You've got to constantly get better. I wasn't born with a silver spoon in my mouth. I'm sure you weren't either. You're here. You're trying to make a go of it in this business. Then don't cut yourself short. Get in there and learn everything you can. Take chances. Think outside of the box. And remember, nothing changes unless you change it. If you have a bad year, you better change something. You better change your prices. You probably got to change a lot of things. Change your prices. Find out, you got to get profitable. Charge more. How are you going to charge more? Well, I better do a better job. I better do a better service. I better do something. You have to find ways to do it. You need to cut your expenses. Whatever it takes to make you profitable, that's where you need to be. Okay? Don't get in this business. Don't do it year after year. And after 5 years, say, I can't make any money at this. You just blew 5 years of your life. Because you were doing the same thing over and over and over again. Think outside the box. I remember when the internet was hot and heavy and I pushed it off. I blew it off to the side. I never should have done that. That move cost me thousands and thousands of dollars, and I hope it doesn't happen to you. Hopefully this video has helped you out. If you want to see any of our other videos, go to familylawnandlandscape.com. They're all on there. I got a lot of helpful hints for you. I'm not gaining anything by this, you guys. I'm not out here selling you software or trying to sell you my lawn care business because you're doing your own. I mean, I'm trying to help you. So if this helps, leave me a note, leave me a comment, check out my other videos, and we'll talk to you soon. Thanks.